If you're here, it means you have questions about the secant line. Probably because you want to know the difference between the secant line and the tangent line.
Poor secant line.
Always being compared to its smarter, more attractive sibling, the tangent line. I guess the secant line is kind of like one of Cinderella's ugly stepsisters. Or maybe one of Snow White's seven dwarves.
And everybody wants to be a princess for Halloween.
Dun 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 dun! Calculus with Krista!
The problem with the poor secant line is that, at least in calculus, we only really need it as far as it helps us get to the tangent line. But then we're done with that.
Oh man!
See, the secant line is a line that cuts through the graph of a function like this. It's just the line that intersects the graph in a couple of spots. The only reason that's interesting to those of us in calculus is that we can take the secant line and turn it into a tangent line. To see how the secant line becomes a tangent line, we'll call the secant line's points of intersection, P and Q, and then draw the tangent line at the point P. We'll keep P locked in place at that exact spot, but we'll say that Q is movable. If we move Q along the graph closer and closer to P, which means that the distance between P and Q is getting smaller and smaller, the slope of the secant line is getting closer and closer to the slope of the tangent line. See how the angle between the secant and tangent lines got smaller? Now if we keep pushing Q closer and closer to P until eventually we eliminate the distance between them and Q is right on top of P, then the secant line becomes the tangent line exactly. And that's the definition of the derivative. Because remember that in the definition of the derivative, we call h the distance between p and q. And we say that when h goes to 0, in other words, when the distance of our two points is eliminated, the result is the derivative, which we already knew to be true, because we know that the tangent line is the derivative at the point of intersection, and we just saw the secant line become the tangent line at the point p.
So remember, even though the tangent line is the one that gets all the glory, I think we can all see that the secant line is pretty important too. For other fun calculus tidbits, make sure you download my calculus ebook by clicking that link down below or the links over here. And that selfish tangent line wouldn't even exist without the secant line.
Poor secant line.